22 countries have shores bordering the Mediterranean, providing various routes across the sea. To the south and the east are the countries people are fleeing or pass through to escape war, poverty, and human rights violations. To the north lies their destination, Europe. It's estimated that 20,000 people have lost their lives crossing the Mediterranean in the past 15 years. Who are the people forced into exodus? In the first months of 2015, most were Syrian, Eritrean, Somali, or Afghan. As soon as new barriers go up, the migrants change routes. The most common are Morocco to Spain via the enclaves of Ceuta and Melilla, Tunisia and Libya to southern Italy, and Turkey to Bulgaria or Greece. Reinforced borders around the Spanish enclaves and the security fence erected in Bulgaria haven't deterred those wanting to leave. They just seek out alternative routes. The one linking Tunisia and Libya to Sicily is currently the most practicable, but also the most deadly. Estimates indicate that in 2014, 3,500 people drowned during the crossing. More than 1,750 have perished since the beginning of 2015. In October 2013, a boat transporting 500 migrants sank, and Italy launched rescue operation Mare Nostrum, saving over 150,000 lives in a single year. But in October 2014, the Italian operation became European, changed its name and its remit. While Mare Nostrum ships used to patrol close to the Libyan coastline searching for and rescuing migrants in distress, the new operation, Triton, is designed above all to protect Europe. Its ships don't venture very far from shore, and the budget has been reduced by two-thirds. The Italian Coast Guard also helps to save migrants, as do privately owned ships, which are obliged under international law to assist anyone in distress. But trawlers and huge merchant navy cargo ships are not equipped to pick up dozens of migrants on small overcrowded boats. Faced with such tragedy, leaders of European Union countries often justify this policy of inaction, arguing that increasing the rescue operation will encourage more migrants to attempt the journey. But the figures prove the opposite. In January 2014, while Mare Nostrum ships roamed the sea, Italy saw nearly 2,100 migrants arrive on its shores. 12 months later, when the operation had been abandoned, they were close to 3,500. The trend was much the same between February 2014 and February 2015. At the beginning of May, MSF sent medical teams aboard two ships, each equipped for several hundred people. Less than 24 hours after the first ship took to sea, 369 people were rescued and taken to Italy.